Yo, what's good, fellas? How y'all doing, man? We back, man. Yeah, I just had to fly in, man. You know, I was at the hotel in Ireland, man. You know, I was at the Marriott, yo. And my man Smitty hit me on the jack. He's like, yo, Rob, man. They hating on us, the devil hating on us on the stream, man. So I just took a chopper all the way from the Marriott, yo. I landed on top of the field, yo. I'm here. Now I'm headed up to the booth, man. How you guys doing, man? Good to see you guys. I'm just getting this straight right quick, man. Gotta rearrange the setup right quick. It's all good. You check the calendar, it's not Thursday. Yeah, man. Celtic Inns. The Celtic Inn sponsored by Marriott. Oh, man, let's see. All right, behind the scenes, I had to come in here. And let me come in here right quick and change up a little bit. You know how it is. Almost there, fellas. Yo, if you're in the chat right now, hit that like button, man. They can't stop this party, man. Can't stop this party, man. The devil, not haters. It can't stop the party, man. We got too many ways, too many outlets, too many people. Supporters, constituents, whatever you want to call them, man. Leadership all helping out. Trying to do what we got to do, man. So, we're gonna hold it down, man. Be with you guys for the evening. I got to go to my team settings to make sure I got the audio down. Because I was doing a lot of practicing behind the scenes. Visual feedback. Volume control. You guys can see what goes on behind the scenes now, man. I got to turn the in-game commentary down. We don't want those bozos talking over the game while I'm talking, you know what I mean? So let's go ahead and turn that down right quick. And then I got to make sure the ticker's off. Well, it doesn't really matter about the ticker anyway. But we don't care about the NFL teams too, so I'm going to keep that off. That's good. And I'm already on the CT. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. Everything should be good there. Smitty has to auto himself. I don't know if I can auto the commissioner, man. I don't know if I got that card. Guys, you got to hit up Smitty. Tell him to auto himself. Let me see. Oh, yeah, I think I can. Toggle. Oh, yeah, I can. Okay, I got the clearance. I got the clearance to auto the commish, man. That's what's up. All right, so we go ahead. Go and just play game. Oh, no, I don't have the clearance. He got to auto himself. I look like I hit auto. I don't know why it's not letting me play the game. Is it saying trying to play the game? Won't let me play the game. Smitty, make sure you delete the Smitty's in the chat right now. Smitty, you got to delete the previous game, man. So maybe fire up your franchise and hit delete. And then toggle yourself autopilot, man, to make sure. See it, Smitty. Give me 1 second, guys. I'm just trying to get stuff straight behind the scenes. If Smitty is in the chat right now, Smitty, you have to delete the old game, man. So fire up your franchise, act like you're going to the franchise online, and delete the franchise. Yeah, not delete the franchise. Ooh, don't delete the franchise. Delete the game that may be paused in a stuck state or whatever. And then make sure you toggle yourself. I think I toggled you already, but. For those of you who are in chat right now, man, just waiting on this game to get started. Please hit that like button. We got a big game tonight, man. I'm going to be calling this one as well. You guys can check this out, man. We got the Diablos going against the Thunderbirds tonight, man. They facing off in another battle. They already had a battle earlier this year. Thunderbirds won that at the end of the game, man, off just the veteran drive by LC3. And so we're all hyped, man, to see that game go down tonight, man, at 8 p.m. I might be able to run it directly after this game, but maybe I should wait till 8 p.m. I'll get a call from the commissioner. We might be able to do back-to-back, but I might need a little break, so we'll see how it goes. But yeah, so you guys can see the poster, cover art for here. If you want to get involved with the RFL, please join our Discord. Get active, man. Get active. Don't let the technical difficulties deter you from joining this awesome league, man. You know, things happen like that all the time. It is what it is. You guys know the internet sucks. So yeah, man. Join the Discord, man. Get active. We have links to become a rookie in a season 5. We got the rookie series coming up in a little bit over a month. So yeah, man. You guys do what you got to do, man. Get active. Get active. Straight up. Go ahead and hit that like button for us. All right, let me see if Smitty has done his part yet. Let's see. Ooh, so I still can't jump on this game yet. I got him on autopilot. Yep. So as soon as he's able to turn that off, then that's what's up, man. For those of you who didn't see our game last week, man, yo, our man Dre Crowell, man, he reached 100 passing touchdowns, 100 touchdowns on the year last weekend, man. We didn't realize it was his 100th. It wasn't until actually I was able to tabulate all of his stats and everything. But Dre Crowell, the face of the RFL, all-time career record, 14,085 yards, 100 touchdowns, only 27 interceptions. Three of those have come this year, and he is 4-for-3 in the playoffs, man. Four out of three. So, yeah, man, decent guy out of Ohio State, superstar dev. This is only his fourth season. I know some of y'all are like, how is he 35 and only his fourth season? Well, in the RFL, we sent forward many, many years to get all the NFL players out of the foul. We don't want any NFL players. And so when the RFL inherited Mr. Dre Crowell, he was 31 years of age. So he reached his 35th year of age here in season 4. And he's just been a monster, man. He's been a monster in that 4 years. In his own right, you know. And we were getting some details on more stats as we start to track the historiography of the RFL. We're starting to see a lot of other people with a lot better stats and stuff, so that'll start coming to you guys as well as we start to track that history. So stay tuned for that. But in his own regard, this is the face of the RFL. He's just touched the lives of so many different people in our community, and we, you know, wish him the best of luck as he embarks on retirement very, very soon for the RFL, man. Okay, so let's go ahead and see if this is gonna work. Coming back in here. All right, let me try to go out of the franchise and load back in. He said he already hit that. Let's go ahead and see. All right. Let's come in here. Oh, man. Yeah, it's not letting me. Sorry, Smitty. It's not letting me. Smitty, maybe jump off the team. Hey guys, tell Smitty to jump off the team and go to another team. Okay, looks like I figured it out. All right, cool. We got it. We got it straight. Never mind, guys. We got it straight. All right, so time to go into this right now. Make sure everything is straight here. Yes, yes, yes. All right, and we are going to hit our ready button. Shout out to everybody in the chat right now, man. Please hit the like button. Join the Discord. We are sorry for the technical difficulties, man, but we are all the way live here in Ireland, man. Dublin, Ireland, about to see the Celtic Tigers, Dre Crowell, go against the Bulldogs of London, man. We got England in the house representing as well. And here we go, man. About that time. You guys excited? I know I'm excited, man. It's your boy Rob Roby, a.k.a. Mix, and we are live in effect for what hopes to be a very, very good ball game between the Celtic Tigers and the London Bulldogs, man. We needed a redo, man. Look at this. It's just a nice, foggy, breezy, windy, rainy day here, but we are out here, man. We out here. Let me get out here. I don't know how to spell out here. O-U-T-C-H-E-A. You're out here. Ready to see these guys get it on the way, man. This is a classic matchup. This is a rematch of the Relocation One Bowl. So both teams looking to make an impact today. And you can see the defensive stats right here. This season in 2035 for the Celtic Tigers, man, making their way to the field. I'm pumped, man. I don't know about you guys, man. For real, for real. Here we go again. And there you go. You see Coach Roby on the sideline talking to his guys as the kick is about to get off here. And look at this, man. It's just really, really windy. You can see the rain. There's Mitchell down there celebrating, trying to pump up the guys. You know what we got to do first, man? We got to pay some bills. So let's go ahead and pay the bills right quick. And there we go, man. Shout out to everybody who came back, man. Loyal supporters, man. Came back for the third time. Came back, man. That's what's up, man. Kickoff's going to be taken out. Nice juke move right there. And they're going to take over the ball at the 25-yard line. You guys will have to excuse me for any mess-ups I may have. This is the last minute game call, so I wasn't able to get familiar with both teams, but I know a little bit about Timmy Merritt, 49 for 82, 496 yards, 4 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. He's looking to dot up the Celtic Tiger secondary, who's been having a rough time trying to keep the pass game from affecting them. Let's go ahead and get this out of your way. And so they're looking to try to stop something here. This is a pass-heavy team. 61% passing from the field. 49% run as they're back in the shotgun right now. 4 down linemen for the Celtic Tigers. Merritt's back, running around, throws in. That's going to be some good defense right there as Crowell wasn't able to catch that ball right there. 2nd and 10. And here we got McBride, Lasco, Bussing, Beasel, and Mills on the O-line here. We got Whitehead, Troop, Wheaton, Wilson, and Lecky. All in the backfield and the wide receiver core here as they come out in the shotgun. 4 wide receivers. Celtic Tigers playing a little bit back now. 4 off the line. They're going to send a blitz here. Let's see what they decide to do. They do send 4. Plenty of time. Passes the ball and gets that up to the 33. So Merritt starting out 1 for 2. 3rd and 2. Let's see what the Celtic Tigers can do here as Lecky gets his first pass on the night. Or the evening, I should say. Coach Roby, they're not really liking that they give up that much yardage on one play. 3rd and 2. Does a good job of keeping his feet in bounds. It looks like, did he lift off before he caught the pass? Guess not. They'll go ahead and credit him with that. 3rd and 2. Single back formation, 2 wide receivers out to the left. Play action. Passes, and that's going to be a wide open route right there. It's going to get a little bit extra yardage on there after he was in coverage. And then gets a little bit scamper after that. 1st and 10 on the 39-yard line. Bench formation for the Bulldogs. Handoff coming to the outside. Has plenty of running scamper. Kicks up the first down. And not what the Celtic Tigers were expecting from the line of scrimmage for the first drive here. You see this, man. There's no one out here on the outside here. Looks like everybody was cheating inside. And that's going to spring the running back to the outside there. 1st down. Back in the backfield.
Here we go.
Merritt in the gun. Passes over the middle and has a man. Nice juke move. Puts up the 1st down there. That's going to be a 1st down for the Bulldogs. As Crowell's going to get his first reception on the day. First down. McNeil on the tackle, 1st and goal. And McNeil on the tackle right there just stops that. Nice juke move right there. Jukes Demore Williams out of his feet right there on his shoes. Ooh, Demore just fell right down, man. So Crowell picking up a big first down conversion right there. So first and goal from the 9. Single back, 2 wide receivers out to the left. Trying to do a little bit of isolation right now. Pat hand the ball off and spin move, no. And Wheaton's going to be swarmed in the backfield. Kelvin Tigers actually getting the backfield an awful lot. You got to watch a little bit of their game tape, man. They get in the backfield in a hurry. That was looks like it was Wilkins back there, the safety. He gets back there and stops that play from developing right there. He's caught up in a block, has the sense enough to break off the block and get the stop right there. Second and goal. From the 11-yard line. Got a wide receiver one-on-one, top of the screen here. Single back, hands the ball off in. A little bit of a hole, but going to be stopped there again. That's going to be Lindsley on the tackle. Lindsley is just a real monster on the outside. And here goes the D-line. McBride, Yates, Baber, and Lindsley are going to make up that explosive D-line. Afrigi, Holmberg, and Blackman are going to make up the linebacker core. And here we go. Mickens, McNeil, Wilkins, and Stroud are going to make up the DBs. Third and goal. Celtic Tigers need a stop here in the red zone. Four down linemen. Merritt drops back, passes over the middle, and that's going to be out the back of the end zone there. And so for the moment, the Celtic Tigers can breathe, as that wasn't 7 points, and it'll just be 3 if they can convert the field goal here. Kick is up, and that's going to be good. So London taking a 3-0 lead. And Coach Roby, he's very animated on the sideline there. So you can see he's already a little bit upset that they're down by 3. Bulldogs coach couldn't be happier. And that ball is going to be kneeled in the end zone. And here comes our man, Mr. Dre Crowell, out to the field. And let's see what he can do. We know that this guy can put up numbers in bunches, but he has struggled here and there in the backfield, taking sacks. So we'll see what he's doing. Those are his numbers on the season right there. We'll see what he can do here in the rain with his Celtic Tigers at home. Rick Arell coming out, 25-yard line, single back. DB's playing off their man. McFarlane in motion, has plenty of time. Worsley fake, and that's going to be a sack. We were just talking about that in the play action. As the line is not getting a lot of blocks for them in the play action, so that puts Drake Carell in a lot of trouble. So that'll be very, very key to see what happens this game when they run that play action here against this 4-6 defense. And you can see the defensive end getting out on the edge here, and Drake Carell don't even see him as he was looking for a man downfield. Had 2 guys short. Not sure why Dre didn't decide to throw that there. Had a man on the drag. But who knows what he was seeing at the time. It is rainy out there. Field conditions a little bit wet and hard to see. Bench formation right here. Box loaded with 7 guys. And here comes Worsley out and runs into a defensive lineman there. He's going to be stopped. 1 rush, 1 yard. Negative 1 yard. Because that's going to be Kaiser on that there. Get the stop. Kaiser's just so big, man. Look at him compared to Worsley, man. Like, you can fit Worsley's whole body inside of Kaiser, man. Look at that. Wow. He's a big guy. He gets that stop right there. Gets a little bit of help. But I think he had it. Coach Roby showing his frustration right now. 3rd and 19. And Dre's got an arm, man. So let's see what he does here. Let's go. Empty set. Stepping back in the pocket. Running around, and let's see what Dre does here, and he's going to run it, and be stopped. So no one to throw to. He just runs it, picks up 9 yards, and that's how the Celtic Tigers' first drive is going to end. 4th and 11 from the 24-yard line. Coach Roby is livid right now. Need to calm down, Coach. I don't want you to pop a blood vessel, man. It's only the first quarter here. And typically, Dre Crowell has really good speed there, but I mean, 3rd and 19 is going to be hard for him to pick up 19 yards on a run play. So that was shut down by the guy underneath here. Punt coming up. And the Bulldogs will receive the ball at the. Looks about 25-yard line is where they're going to mark it. So good punt. And London back up as they come back out here. Shout out to the chat right now. Justin Jones, Bill Nicholson, Carl Prince. Adam, how you doing, my man? Levi Marks. Zayas, what's good? Commissioner, how you doing? Shout out to everybody in the chat right now, man. Appreciate you guys. Merritt stepping back in the gun. Passes over the middle and has him in. Gets it out to the 35. Merritt, 4 out of 6. 57 passing yards. So Celtic Tigers showing that they are not able to defend the pass very well this season so far, as quarterbacks are having huge days against them. Oh, man, this is a spread formation. Going to hand the ball off inside zone here, and he's going to be stopped right at the line. I think he's going to pick up that first down, though. Yes, he does. So Troop picks up the first down and points the other direction. So a little bit of jaw drawing going on between the defense and offense right now. As this is a highly anticipated game, and again, this is a rematch of the Relocation Bowl 1 that was 4 years ago. So London looking to get some revenge here against the Bulldogs, who absolutely annihilated them in that first game. And that's going to be a stop right there as Wheaton gets stopped in the backfield, 2nd and 13. That's going to be DeMoy Williams on the stop. Another handoff inside and has plenty of daylight there, and just gets crushed right there by McNeil, but not before he gets the first down. So the inside zone working really well right now for the Bulldogs. 3-0, Bulldogs. 5 wide receivers. Merritt stepping back. In trouble, and that's a sack right there. And you know, as bad as the secondary seems to be for the Celtic Tigers, the offensive line and the DB corps are that much greater. So it's kind of an odd balance, you know. They get a lot of pressure around the edges, make it hard for quarterbacks at times. If they can get enough pressure in this game, they stand a chance of beating the Bulldogs. If they can't get enough pressure, then it might be lights out for them very, very early here. What's this gonna be? 2nd and 21. And a 35. 4 down line. I mean, you see they got the box stacked right now. Handoff coming in. He's just running through holes right now. That's going to be true. 3 rushes, 23 yards. That's the shoulder pass there. 3rd and 13. So Troop looking pretty good for the Bulldogs right now. Troop, a halfback out of Florida State. FSU. 29 years old, star dev, 5'11", 223. So getting it done right now for the Bulldogs. They can't be any happier. Offset formation. Fakes the handoff, goes over the middle, and that's a dot right there as no one was able to cover him. And he's going to get down to the 23-yard line. So Merritt with a huge, huge conversion right there on third. And he gets that ball out to number 89, and that's going to be Whitehead. Stanley Whitehead out of Notre Dame, superstar dev. 6'2", 213, man. Looking to make an impact this game. Kelton Tigers are going to have their hands full with that guy this year. This game. Handoff coming in, and that's going to be another stop right there as DeMorey, it's like DeMorey Williams gets in on the play. So Matt Wheaton, last week, 10 rushes, 55 yards. He only has 106 yards on the season. Still very early here. 2nd and 8 from the 21. Bulldogs pressing again. 4 down linemen. 3 linebackers. McDonald in motion. Another handoff, and that's going to be a stop right there as Lindsley gets in on the stop from Wheaton. So 3rd and 7, and the Bulldogs may want to rethink running around Lindsley too much. We saw him last week, man. 4 sacks and a string of tackles. He was all day in the backfield. 3rd and 7. Let's see if the Celtic Tigers can stop him right here. 3 linebackers underneath. 4 down linemen. Lucky coming in motion. Merritt stepping back in the gun. Passes and maybe a stop. Yes, they get a stop after he breaks the tackle. And that's going to be Wilkins, I believe, going to come in and stop him. Or Stroud, one. Mickens, one tackle. I'm sorry. So fourth and one. And McNeil just couldn't hold him. Try to throw a shoulder tackle there. You got to wrap up, man. Try to throw a shoulder right there, and not gonna knock over Wheaton. Wheaton said no. I got plenty of power, brother. Nick is coming in with the save. So two good stops for the Celtic Tigers, and they're only gonna be down by six if the Bulldogs convert this, which I think they will, and they do. So 6-0. After two very, very good, impressive drives for the Bulldogs. And he just puts that right through the middle there. Rain not an issue, obviously, for the kicker. Celtic Tigers looking to receive the ball here. And this is going to be kicked to the end zone. He's just going to kneel it again. Excuse me. So out comes Crowell. There's Nayani right there talking to Crowell as they jog out. Maybe something going on between these two here in this drive. As the Celtic Tigers are looking to stay inside of this game and not get down by too much here at home. They only have a negative one total yard right now? Interesting. Rushing yards? No, yeah, can't be right. Madden's math is terrible. But anyway, offset. Passes the ball and has a man. And he gets that to Worsley. Worsley, a dual threat, can receive and can run the ball. And this is going to be Devin Trung, Nielsen, Yates, and Borum are going to be on the offensive line. Nayani, Henderson, Worsley, Colvin, and Barrow are all going to be the wide receiver and halfback core tight ends as well. Worsley, one reception, 3 yards. Second and seven. Celtic Tigers in the gun. Trying to spread it out. Nice handoff to Worsley, and Worsley immediately runs into his own lineman there. Keegler going to get the tackle. Go. Hoover, Rodine, Kaiser are going to be on the D-line for the Bulldogs. Frieden, Bain, Robbins, and Ishmael are going to be the middle linebackers. Gent, Poole, Cosby, and Cohen are going to make up the secondary. And the Celtics Tigers need to try to get Trey Worsley going. He's very, very explosive. They hadn't gotten him going yet this season. He's led in rushing, I believe, for 2 out of 3 seasons here in the RFL. That's going to be a screen. They get it to Worsley, and there he is right there. First down, spin move. Keeps going to the sideline and going to get a fumble at the end of that play. So an excellent, excellent run. Does a little bit too much there. Gets clobbered. And that's going to be a fumble going the other way for the Bulldogs. Now I know Trey Worsley wants that one back right there. Maybe should have went out of bounds. He's a little flashy when he wants to be. Nice spin move works there. Runs to his own man. Gets to the outside. Thought he was going out of bounds, but he tries to juke it back inside. And you can't do that, man. You got to get out of bounds. You got to get out of bounds there. Drake Carroll did the same thing last week. And these Celtic Tigers are learning very, very early. And I'm sure Coach Roby is livid right now. As that's a clean fumble. And that's going the other way for the Bulldogs. Great tackle by the Bulldogs. As Stanley Whitehead comes out. He's got 11 receptions on the season, 233 yards, and one touchdown. Bulldogs looking to go up here at the 50-yard line. Great field position. They like to spread it out here against this Celtic Tiger secondary. Murray back in. Throws and has a man right there and does it wisely. Gets out of bounds as the field condition is very, very difficult to maneuver around. He slid a little bit. And smart enough to get out of bounds instead of taking a hit right there. Live to see another day. Look at this. Kind of misses his footing there. Grips the ball tight. Just very, very smart. Not being too fancy, gets out of bounds. That's how you do it, man. First and 10. And looks like the first quarter is going to draw down. And the Celtic Tigers probably need a break here. So I guess they'll go ahead and take that one. As we start the second quarter. Shout out to everybody here. This is the RFL game day. We got a game at 8 p.m. tonight as well, man. So you want to check that out. That's going to be the Diablos, the Mexico City Diablos versus the Toronto Thunderbirds. The Thunderbirds. I still don't have a Canadian accent yet. I don't know what's going on. Shout out to my boy Mitch, man, in the chat. And we are live here for the second quarter of action, man. Let's see if this game picks up any. And it's a dog fight here in the rain, and Roby wants to talk it over with his guys. As the defense is out there on the field in the trenches. Nick Brissett playing off. They got two backs here. Let's see how this works out, really. And a nice stop right there. That's going to be Holmberg, I believe, on the tackle. Holmberg gets in the backfield very, very quick there. And these linebackers for the Celtic Tigers are very, very fast. It's Holmberg out of Florida. Superstar dev, 6'2", 234, 25 years old. That's the middle linebacker on the outside, man. Handoff coming in and almost another stop, but this time he's going to run into a defender here. 36. It's going to be DeMori Williams on the tackle.
Here we go now. So
four wide for the Celtic Tigers. Four wide set. Passes up and gets the nice connection there. He's going to get that to Crowell. Merritt, 8 for 10 on the day so far, man. This is very, very similar to last week when Mackey was something like 16 of 18 in the first half. So quarterback's doing very, very well against these Celtic Tigers earlier on here. But let's just see if the game plan develops. I mean, the Celtic Tigers, you know, they start slow. And they tend to have amazing comebacks and stay in the game. So surprisingly, this game is not 14-0 right now. It's only 6-0. Down line, we got two middle linebackers in the middle. I think they're gonna drop back in the zone. Let's see what they do here. Lecky on the motion and pressure coming in, lobs the ball, and it's gonna be a flag. It's probably gonna be a pass interference. He looks like he was all over his back right there. Let's see what the call is.
Pass interference.
Yes, pass interference on the defense. He was all over his back right there, man. You can't do that. So the Bulldogs get a break there in the red zone. Single back formation, four down linemen, three linebackers, run. He can spin move and tries to truck. A man gets up a good yardage on the play, second and goal from the two. Motion. Hand off to Whedon. He just walks right into the end zone there. Walks right into the end zone. And now he's just swerving. So a touchdown right there for the Bulldogs. 12-0. They might go for two here to make it even 14. Let's see what they decide to do. And no one even touches him here. He just walks. He walks through there. So touchdown. So the Bulldogs with lots of momentum right now as they get the touchdown. Kick is up, and that's going to be good. So they opt out to go for the two-point conversion and make it 13. And they'll be kicking off again. 12 minutes and 24 seconds left. And the ball's being returned right now, and they get it out to the 31-yard line. On the day, two rushes and 1 yard, that's not going to work, man. And a fumble, that's not going to work for the Celtic Tigers right now. Drake Carwell comes back out, 160 yards to 25 yards. Celtic Tigers got to get something going here. Four down linemen, three linebackers. McFarlane in the motion here, fakes the handoff in the pocket, passes over the middle and has a man wide open. Down to the 36. So Drake Carwell, 3 for 3. So we've seen this before. Drake Carwell just has an amazing knack just to be able to convert the big play. A lot of dinks and dunks, and then sometimes he just finds the open man and they just get wide open. And the Celtic Tigers have lived on this arm of his and the clutchness of if that's even a word, of Drake Carwell in game time situations. So a huge conversion right there, right back down the field. That's what they do here with two backs in the backfield. That was Barrow on the reception. Drake Carwell gets the handoff to Worsley, and Worsley going to be stopped at the line. May have picked up one there. Second and eight, picks up two.
Come on, let's go! White 90!
Weak formation right there, almost jumped off sides. And a few juke moves right there for Worsley. Third and six here. Ishmael on the tackle. So Celtic Tigers moving a little bit, at least for the moment they're in field goal range. Let's see what they can do here on third and six. Ah, coming out with five wide receivers. Breakwell back, throws over the middle, and oh, throws a dud. It's going to be his first miss on the day as he was not able to connect with Nayani. The field position showing it there. Slowing him down just a little bit. Nayani usually would catch that on a slant. Dre just throws that to the ground there. I don't know what he saw there. So Tyrus Wiley out to kick the field goal. Let's see if Celtic Tigers can draw blood here. Oh, it's a fake, and he rolls around, and Justin Jones passes to alignment to Barry Borum. Oh, wow. So that's going to be Crandell Cooper, who's going to be injured. Devine is going to catch the ball, and that was Justin Jones. If y'all haven't seen Justin Jones, man, this guy can play in this offense. Coach Roby mentioned that you might see a little bit of Justin Jones tonight. We're not sure. But he mentioned that there's a possibility you might see a few trick plays with him. And he just throws an absolute dart to the lineman who catches it. Maybe want to slim that guy down, man, and make him a tight end or something, coach. So we got to see Justin Jones pass. Let's see if Drake Howell can get these guys into the end zone here. Steps back, passes over the middle, has a man, and a jumping catch right there, which passes almost overthrown. And Stimson, who they've talked a lot about as well. This guy's got mega speed. He gets out into the open, and he's very difficult to catch. So you got to watch out for him as well. Bain laying down the punishment on the defensive side of things. Crushes Stimson right there, and Stimson holds on to it. Second and five. Wide split out. Hands the ball off to Worsley, and Worsley still going, and Juke moves inside. So Worsley still trying to turn his legs here and fight. If you've seen Worsley in the past 3 years, you know that he has mega potential. Right now he's struggling. He's had two home games that have been rained and flooded out. So I know he's just ready for a bright sunny day so he can start his season four career on the right footing here. Drake Well steps back, passes to the screen route, and there it goes as a first down. Juke move into the end zone, and that's going to be Barrow. DJ Barrow for the touchdown right there. It gets clobbered by Colvin in the rain. Colvin just goes over and celebrates with him and just clobbers Barrow down to the ground. Nice screen, nice execution. DJ Barrow with the right footing, switches hands with the ball so he doesn't get a fumble. And he just comes in and celebrates there. Celtic Tigers get on the board right here as Bain wasn't able to stop. Bain got juked out of his shoes right there. And Burrow very excited about that. I hope they saw the replay with Colvin comes in and tries to celebrate with him. Here he goes. Oof. Oh, man, he just fell back. It was so funny, man. All right, so the Celtic Tigers on the board. Ball is up, and that's going to be good. So Celtic Tigers on the board 13-7. 8:45 left in the second quarter. If you are into the RFL, make sure you hit the like button first. Got to get those likes. We shout out to everybody who are still here with us grinding through the technical difficulties. We've corrected them, and we are ready to continue a nice, awesome day or evening of football here in the RFL. Join the Discord. Somebody can put a Discord link out there. Get your career started today, or just join the community and just, you know, stalk us or something, huh? And the Bulldogs are going to take that and kneel it in the end zone, bring it out to the 25. So first and 10, Merritt coming back out. So the game trends now are Dublin has 94 yards as opposed to 25. Man-to-man on the outside. Merritt passes, and oof, nice diving catch right there. I think that was Williams, first and 10. 4-3 for the Celtic Tigers. Hands the ball off, running through the middle, and trucks a man, runs into McBride right there for a second. McBride not an easy guy to run over. Four down lineman, still a 4-3, playing a little soft on the outside here, second and one. Run incoming, and gets a couple on the play right there, so Wheaton has 11 rushes for 40 yards right now. And we've seen this before, the Celtic Tigers play a bend but don't break kind of defense. So, you know, you think you got things going, they sucker you into the running game, and then they get a defensive stop from the secondary, and that's how they get turnovers. So we'll see what goes on here. Bulldogs looking to pass, it looks like. First and 10, Merritt stepping back, throws over the middle, and a nice punishing hit right there. He picks up 7 yards on the play. Second and 3. This looks like a run here. Loads of linemen down on the line right there. Let's see what they do here. Hands the ball off, and nice juke move to get to the line of scrimmage. And Wheaton just gets the first down, so first and 10, they convert it. Another four downs for them here. Celtic Tigers get a little bit of field behind them, but they need to be able to stop them right here to keep them to only a field goal. Wheaton with a little nifty little juke move right there and picks up the first down at the last moment. Let's see what they do here. First and 10 from the 38-yard line. Four down, three linebackers. Celtic Tigers still playing way off these receivers here. Offset formation is right and comes in to motion. Merritt going to step back to pass. Passes over the middle again, and this time that's going to be broken up. So 10 of 13, 140 yards. Second and 10 as the Celtic Tigers are all over that right there with the linebacker core. Another four down lineman. Okay, so it looks like they're trying to fool him here. We've got one linebacker here, but watch for Demore Williams in this right here. Passes over, and Demore Williams, no, that's going to be Holmberg right there, who's going to stop him for third and one. So a little bit of trickery right there. They thought they had had a deeper play right there in the gun. Third and one. Celtic Tigers able to clamp down in the man coverage. So third and one, let's see what the Bulldogs are gonna do here. Celtic Tigers coming out with still four linemen. Okay, they got a guy on the outside here.
Hey, hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
They send him, and that's gonna be stuffed right there, and that's what they do. They feed you and they feed you. They let you get the run a little bit. They pick up a stop on third and one. And now it's gonna be fourth and one. Let's see what they're gonna do here. I guess they'll try to kick the field goal. And this rain right here hasn't affected them so far. That's a big, big stop right there for the Celtic Tigers. Fourth and one. Kick is up, and it looks like it's gonna be good. Yep, it's good. So 16-7. 9-point lead for London. That ball was good, man. He's just right down the middle right there. Looks like the rain has cleared up a little bit here. Got a little bit of clear skies going on. Let's see how that affects the rest of the game. Ball is received here. Oof. And he gets out to the 25 there. Thought he was going to break that tackle right there. That should be DJ Barrow returning the ball. And Drake Cowell and company come back out, down by only 9. 3:44 left to go in the second quarter. So they're still hanging in this game a little bit, even though they're down. Bulldogs have 206 total yards.
Here we go. White 90.
Falling. In motion. Play action. Dre in the pocket, running around, and what's he going to do? He's going to try to throw the ball, but nowhere to throw it, and he's going to be sacked for a 7-yard loss, second and 17, and that's his second sack of the day. So he goes to the play action read, and look at this, man. Everyone's covered. They got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 DBs. I guess that must have been a dime. Look. Maybe a dime look, I'm not sure. And then Crowell just gets toppled right there. My two Bulldog defenders. Nowhere to throw to. Very, very good coverage. Second and 17.
Here we go. One.
Snap is up, and they run the ball this time. And there's Worsley. And, man, you know, if he would just bounce it to the outside, he may get a whole lot more yardage. But he just decided to cut right into the defender there. He had plenty of room, daylight, between him and the first down line. Third and 13. A man in the slot uncovered. Dre in the pocket. Passes. Has a man to the outside. And that's going to be a converted pass play for Dre Cowell. 6 out of 7. First down as he passes a great, great pass to the outplay right there. Or maybe a smash is what they ran there. Not exactly sure. Didn't see the route. Carell going to talk it over with Roby. Roby and Carell not on the same page since Roby took over last October during the offseason. Had several news headlines come out that Dre Carell may have been dealt away or been trying to get traded. That not the case, though, as they both have become very, very good friends. Looking to try to get to a relocation bowl this year. Worsley coming out. Going to line up as a receiver here. Dre in the pocket. Dre passes, has a man. So Dre Carell 7 for 8, and they're going to go with a hurry-up offense right here in the two-minute drill. Second and 4. 4 wide receivers here. Against the 4-3. Dre in the pocket. Dre running around and just runs right into a man right there. Kaiser has 2 sacks, 3 tackles. Third and 16.
Here we go.
I imagine they don't try to do too much here. Just going to hand the ball off and punt the ball away. So a timeout by the Bulldogs is they're going to be a little bit aggressive, it looks like, on this drive here. 4th and 17. Celtic Tigers got to punt it away. Down 16 to 7. So 4th and 17, a minute and 26 seconds left in the half, and here's the punt. And this may be downed at the 1-yard line, 2-yard line. So an excellent punt. Excellent, excellent punt right there. The Celtic Tigers will take that. They were just stopped. And that's going to be Hudson O'Donnell out of Texas Tech. 6'1", 200 pounds, and 32 years of age. Getting up there. First and 10 from the 2-yard line. Now be careful here because the Celtic Tigers have a really awesome blitz from the outside here. So any funny business in the backfield, this may be a safety. Wheaton's going to run, and he picks up enough yards right there. So eliminate the safety for now. Give Wheaton 6 yards. He has 49 and a touchdown on the night. A minute and 6 seconds left to go from the 8-yard line. Time's going to expire down. 4-down linemen. Merritt in the gun right now. Soft coverage on the outside here. Merritt in the gun. Passes and gets a man down to the 10. Someone yelling out, here comes the boom. I haven't heard that in years. 16-7 as DeMorey Williams is going to get the tackle here. Actually, I'm sorry. That's right. Looked like it was going to be nil, but that's actually DeMorey Williams. I was right. So a little bit of a check down right here. Nothing special. And it looks like that's how the first half is going to end. Let's see what they do here. Yep, 7 seconds, 5, 4, 3, 2, and that's going to be it. And that's going to be the end of the first half as Coach Roby and the Celtic Tigers are down at home, 16-7. Shout out to everybody who's still here grinding with us. If you're watching the chat right now, please hit the like button. I know this is probably your third time for some of you, but we really are happy that you guys decided to kick it with us. Let us get this game off, man. Stay with us. We have another game coming up at the end of this one. I think we might actually have that game at 8 p.m. It's the Thunderbirds and the Diablos. We'll make an announcement toward the end of the game here. But, yeah, big day of football for the RFL. It continues. As Dre Correll and company are going to get the ball back here. And why does it look like the halftime show? Oh, they're just showing a replay. I haven't seen this. So they're showing all of Dre Correll's sacks. I haven't seen a game do this before, guys. Okay, cool. But they're showing all Dre Correll's sacks here. As he was shut down in the first half. Hoping to turn things around here for his team. And extend to 3-0. Hand off to Worsley. And Worsley gets a few yards in the play. Second and 7. How you doing, Coach Brown? Shout out to Justin Jones, Jake, Zayas, Saeed, Chrome, and many, many more in the chat right now. Bench formation. Ray has to get this one off. He does. Steps back, passes wide open. Over the middle right there. Has a man. Dre Correll, 8 of 9. And that's going to be Barrow again. So Barrow eating up underneath right now, the underneath zone. It's wide open against those linebackers right there. Linebacker not fast enough. And Barrow's a little guy, man, but he has big speed and big heart, man. He can get downfield in a hurry. Handoff and crushed at the line right there. So Worsley still not able to get the run game going tonight. 9 carries, 14 yards, 2nd and 11. Two bats in the backfield. Fullback. Maybe another run right here. Let's see if they do. And they do run it to Worsley. Juke move and Worsley. Almost another spin move right there. Set 10 rushes, 22 yards. So he's almost able to get the first down right there. Had a huge fumble earlier and spelled disaster for the Celtic Tigers drive and momentum at that point. Trying to redeem himself. Not someone who's known to fumble, but there is a slight hurricane outside right now. So maybe his gloves are just wet. Anyway, 3rd and 3 from the 47-yard line. 3 wide receivers at the top of the screen. Way back in the gun, passes over the middle, and has a man over the middle, and that's going to be Nayani, it looks like. No, Stimson, I'm sorry. Stimson, a pickup from the Celtic Tigers after they traded away Malcolm Wiley to the Elks, picked up Stimson. He's been phenomenal for them. 6'6", 233, out of UNLV. Running rubble, okay? 26 years of age. Three wide receivers. Hand off. And where's he battling for some yards right now? See you out there, Nation. How you doing, my man? Michi Boy Gaming. 2nd and 6. Four down linemen, 3 linebackers. He'd be playing way off. Another run. That's going to be Big Henderson. He has some room. He gets the first down, so 1 rush, 9 yards. They like to keep him going north, south, not east, west. If you want to think of this back, you want to think of big Brandon Jacobs of the Giants back in the day. That's who this guy is, but you got to keep him north and south. If he starts running east, west, it's over. In the meantime, it's going to be a handoff. Trey Worsley, 12 rushes, 30 yards. Second and 6. Justin Jones in the check, yelling Henny. Come on, let's go! Big Henny. Damian Henny out of Memphis. And that's going to be a first down for Worsley. So the run game slowly churning right now for the Celtic Tigers. And that's what they like. They like to run Worsley. And they can run Worsley effective. And when he can be the impact player for this Celtic Tiger offense, that allows Dre Correll to get lots of passes downfield. Dre Correll, more of a West Coast style passer. Used to pass deep a lot, but in later years, he's lost the arm ability. He's moved into more of a West Coast, and he can dart from anywhere on field underneath the zone. Getting Worsley going again, another big game. And So that's going to, actually, that's not Royce, that's Davis, the pickup after they lost Nina a few weeks ago. So Davis coming in, getting some work in for the Celtic Tigers out of free agency. Second and three. Dre back, passes and has him in, and that's going to be Barrow again in the zone. So Crowell, despite being down 16 for 17, is currently 10 for 12 or something like that on the night. And that's actually, no, that's not Barrow. That's going to be number 30. And we got to go ahead and get a jersey on him. And then Davis, that's the halfback. Okay, nice. So Tyrone Davis getting in the pass game right now. 5-9 out of Oregon. Pick up last week or 2 weeks ago after they lost Nana for 5 weeks. First and goal. And that's going to be Worsley. And you see, and that's what Worsley does. That's what they like to do. They like to get those short intermediate passes, and then they like to run Worsley against the zone or against the rush. And that's what happens here. So Celtic Tigers get on the board. This is a 16-14 ball game, and all of a sudden this looks like it's going to be a good matchup here. Worsley just crosses the line untouched. Touchdown Celtic Tigers. And it is absolutely loud in this stadium right now as the Celtic Tiger family. We're all here, people roaring. Fireworks going off in the background. And I imagine if they win this game tonight and go 3-0, they're gonna have a huge celebration as they have a couple of bye weeks going on, or the next couple of weeks. And then they actually meet the London Bulldogs again in 2 weeks. So it'll be a revenge game for one or the other. 16-14, Celtic Tigers with a little bit of momentum right now as the Bulldogs are going to receive, and they're going to take this one out. Gets down. And a few moves here and almost broke that one. Gets to the 31. So a great run. Great field position for the Bulldogs to start off with as Merritt and company will come back on the field. There's Tat McDonald and Farmer. Troop with 4 rushes, 26 yards, averaging 6.5 on the ground. Total yards looking a little bit more in sync. Handoff, and that's going to be stopped right here. And that's going to be, is that Baber? Yep, that's Baber. Big Baber, Big Baby. They call him Big Baby Baber on the D lines. Well, Big Baby gets in the backfield and stops the run for 1 yard loss, second and 11. Look at this. Just crushed in the back. That's crushed meat. That's a big boy. That's big meat, as I like to say. Big meat. D-line wanted to talk it over for a second. It's like a looking formation here. If not mistaken. Handoff comes in, and Wheaton's going to be stopped again. So we told you, they like to bait with the run play. The defense comes in. They swoop it. They turn it into a 3rd and 8, and now the secondary just has to try to stop the pass. Let's see if they protect the sticks here. 3rd and 8. Celtic Tigers going with a 4-3. The rush is coming in. Merritt steps back and just dots him right over the middle here. So they blitz the safety, it looks like. And one of the corners here. Get that to the 48. So a tough break right there. A good break for the Bulldogs. Tough break for the Celtic Tigers right there. Because they sent the blitz, and that's going to leave a man under the drag. Wide open under the field. And I think they know that. I think they know that leaves them open. I think they're just contingent on getting pressure from the outside, which is what they've been building this, what Roby's been building this defense to do. Let's just see what they do here. Nickel two, man. Handoff incoming, and that's going to be a stop right there. No, Wheaton's still on his feet and finally going to be brought down by McBride and company. 2nd and 9. Great agility right there for Wheaton and power to stay on his feet, but it's hard to run against this team right here. 2nd and 9. Pressure incoming, and they throw the screen, and for the moment he's still up on his feet and gonna be dropped down at the 44. Merritt 14 of 17. We saw this last week. 3rd and 2. Holmberg with his 5th tackle on the night. And that was just a great executed screen. Almost picked up the first down. Blocks everywhere. His troops fast enough to get it off. And very, very good play. Old school, but a very good play to run against a team that likes to blitz the outside. Third and two. DB's playing a little soft here. Maybe should be a little closer. Oh, they flick it to Whedon, and no, going to be stopped in the backfield, and that's, who is that again? That's going to be Big Yates. That's going to be Big Yates. Fourth and five. So he gets back there and just destroys Whedon on the play right there. The punt is going to come up, and now Dre Crowell and company get a chance to take the ball back downfield. Maybe take the lead. Let's see what they get to do. Trey Worsley, 14 rushes, 42 yards, 3 yards per carry, and a touchdown. Looking a lot better on after that last drive that they had. Let's see if he can continue this momentum right here. 4 down linemen, 2-3 linebackers.
Here we go. White,
nine. Rickerell, pump fake passes. That's a wide receiver screen there. Drake Roll 11 to 12, 120 yards, one touchdown. As Burrell's not able to break that one this time. Second and 12. Artis Payne on the tackle. Burrell just couldn't get his footing there. He's going to be clobbered by two defenders. Second and 12 from the 20 yard line. Nice run, and there's Worsley. Spin move, and gets up to the 36-yard line. And that's what they like to see out of Worsley, man. Nice spin move, his patented move he likes to use. And if he breaks that spin move, that can be big yardage in the open field. So Coach Roby's happy about that. Needs to get back to the sideline. Look at this, man. Wide open, no one touches him. Spin move right here. Drop down, first down. Move the chains. The Bulldogs trying to adjust to this running game right now. It's being very, very effective. Loading the box right now to look for a pass here, a play action. Let's see what they do here. And that's going to be a run. Nice run again by Worsley. So, okay. Celtic Tiger saying, hey, we're going to run the ball, man. So they run the ball here, second and two. Plenty of space in the flats out there. Let's see what they do here. Looks like Henderson's in the game. Henderson running, and they get him a spin move, and he picks up the first down. So two rushes, 13 yards for Henderson. Henderson a pickup in the draft out of Memphis. This guy's 6'5", 255. 6'5", 2. I mean, this guy's the size of a truck, man. Look at this guy. Spin moves. And he's like a falling tree, man. He's very hard to tackle. Very, very hard. Take down. First and 10.
Here we go.
And there's Worsley still moving, still turning those legs. He got 70 yards, 17 rushes, 70 yards, one touchdown. Looks like this Bulldogs defense is getting a little bit tired right now as they're still loading the box. Man on man on the outside. There's another run. And that's going to be Worsley again. Picks up another 3 yards on the play. So third and four here. And that's going to be the end of the third quarter. Got a little bit of a boo from the crowd. Not sure what's going on down the field. Maybe they wanted a face mask and didn't get it. And the rain's starting to come down a little bit more here as we got a very tight ball game, 16 to 14. In favor of the Bulldogs, going the other way now. So Drake Howell looks like he has the wind at his back now. Third and four. Back in the pocket, passes over the middle, and oh man, throws it into coverage right there, not able to get it. That's gonna be his second missed pass on the day, fourth and four, and the Celtic Tigers will punt it away. If they don't run a fake. Ball is back. McDonald's going to punt it up. And let's see where he puts this one. And that one's going to be kicked out to the 13. So a good punt. Pins it back to the 13. Merritt and company coming back out. Look right now for the Celtic Tigers. And off coverage. Ball is in. And ball is ran into the middle there. And Wheaton looked like he was going to slip that right there. 19 rushes, 52 yards. He picks up two on the play. Holmberg on the tackle. Second and eight. Another handoff, and it's going to be stuffed down. No, he's going to keep going. Just trucks, absolutely trucks the defense there, and he's off to the races as he's going to the 30, to the 20, to the 10. He's going to get caught. Oh, no, and he does get caught, though. So Wilkins catches him, and Troop, after an amazing run, is going to be dropped at the 2-yard line. Wow. So not looking good for the Bulldogs, and we can only pray with that young man right there, as he's going to be stopped at the 2. Maybe look still on the bench like he might be okay. Maybe out for the game. So he broke a big play. Just a huge play right there.
Here we go now. Green 39.
And that's going to be McBride. No, sir. Says McBride. That's his first tackle of the game. Split backs for the Bulldogs. They got man-on-man coverage outside. Fakes the run. Passes out. And going to be crushed right there. So Wheaton stopped again in the backfield. And this is what the Celtic Tigers like to do. They like to turn it up around this red zone here. They get in the backfield very, very easy. Let's see if they send somebody here on third and goal. Looks like they're going to drop back into man-man coverage. So they're going to play underneath. Two linebackers, four linemen down. Crowell in the motion, defense adjusting. Merritt back in the pocket, gonna throw the middle, and no, he's gonna be stopped right there, and the crowd is happy about that as the defense saves 7 points. So an excellent, excellent rundown by Wilkins on the huge play from Troop. Stops him at the 2, and the Celtic Tigers make a defensive stand, and I mean, that could have been 7, it turns into 3, only 3, and for the moment, the Celtic Tigers looking like they got a little bit of momentum right now. Let's see what they can do on offense. Let's watch the fake now. 12 minutes left. And the ball is up. And that's going to be good. So 19-14. 5 points separating these two teams. Still very much anyone's ball game right now. And this is a dogfight, an absolute dogfight. I'm pretty sure the Celtic Tigers are happy to even be in this ball game after that relocation bowl that they lost that year and just got destroyed, didn't do much of anything. If you want to check that game out, all you got to do is just put in Celtic Tigers versus Bulldogs relocation bowl season 1. Check that here on YouTube. While you're at it, hit that subscribe button and definitely hit the like button here. We are still underway, 11 minutes and 47 seconds left, and the GOAT comes back out on the field, Dre Crowell. See if he can lead his team to another fourth quarter victory.
Here we go.
Four wide receivers. Dre back in the gun. Passes and dots right there up to the 42-yard line. And man, they are absolutely killing the slant play right now against the Bulldogs. It's going to be Barrow again on the slant. And every time I'm seeing Barrow open, he's just wide open. No one's on him. So there's obviously a mismatch that the Celtic Tigers are liking here in the passing game right now. So Dre's going to opt to stay in the gun. This time it's an offset, though. They have a block, two blocking tight ends. Three, actually. Pass over the middle, and that's going to be a conversion. To the 47, second and 6. How you doing, Jack? Connor, how you doing? Coach Tor, Nashawn. You guys are awesome. Hey, Jack, that's cool, man. We appreciate that. That actually is controlled by a member of our community named Mitch. So shout out to Mitch, man. I noticed he's been posting those Instagram photos. That's really dope. Offset formation, Drake Orwell.
Here we go.
In the gun. Let's see what he does here. Steps back, fires over the middle, has a man. And there's his man up to the 42. So Drake Orwell, 14 to 16, one touchdown. Four wide receivers, still an offset here. So this is an offset gun tray, it looks like. Drake Orwell running around, passes, has a man this time. And he's going to run all the way to the 32. That's going to be Worsley on the play. Not able to get the first down, but extends. Second and inches. Henderson in the backfield. That's going to be an offsides. That's probably going to be on the offense, though. The Celtic Tigers have had a problem here in this part of the field with the offense, with the line jumping offsides. They're going to need a little bit more discipline here in this field range. So they take themselves back 5 yards after second and inches, after a great catch and extension by Worsley. Way back in the gun, passes, has a man, lofts it, a nice route, nice pass, and that should be a flag. Is that going to be a defensive penalty? Let's see what they're going to call that.
Personal foul.
Personal foul.
Roughness.
Yes, he was out of bounds. And the Celtic Tigers are going to take that unnecessary roughness right there. This field is slick. You can't be doing that, young man.
Automatic.
They get it to the
14, down.
19 to 14. Celtic Tigers taking over on the 14. And just a nice pass. That was a catch by Thurman. Margarito Thurman, man. That guy has a lot of upswing.
Come on, let's go.
He picked him up at a free agency. Four wide receivers right now. Drake Orwell in the pocket. He's going to be sacked. He's going to be brought down as he tried to escape Friedman. And Friedman just got those bear claws on him. Second and 18.
Here we go.
And that's another offsides. The Celtic Tigers did this last week. The same exact thing. Jumping offsides. In the red zone.
Start offense.
Or near the red zone. They take themselves back again. Second and 23.
Here we go.
Same formation. Drake Orwell barking out calls. Gets it off this time. Throws. Has a safety valve. And going to get that a few yards. 17 for 19. Third and 21. So I imagine he's going to take a shot here. Or just dump it off. Underneath. Let's see what he does. Dre running backwards, passes, and doesn't have anybody there. I don't know who he's throwing to. I guess he just threw it away. So the Celtic Tigers will settle for a field goal right now and get themselves a little bit closer to the Bulldogs. If they can make it, they can convert it. Fourth and 21. Ball is up, and kick is good. 19 to 17, Celtic Tigers knocking on the door. Bulldogs, a lot of pressure right now. They got to keep the lead here. They need a scoring drive right here to keep this lead. At the very minimum, they need 6 points to keep this lead. 19 to 17, kick is up. And I thought I was going to bring it out for a second, but decides to play it safe. And the Bulldogs will start their drive here in the fourth quarter. 7:22 left. And the 25, Griffin Troop, 110 yards a day, 11 reception yards, 121 yards total. I guess he appears to be okay now. He was injured earlier. Had to sit on the bench. I think he's back in the game, though.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
4-3
Green,
situation.
39.
Bunch set for the Bulldogs. They pass it over, and it's going to be stopped down. At the 57, Blackman was all over that. Second and 9. On the gun here, so the Bulldogs opting to pass. He's got to run this down. Oh, they do hand it off, and McBride gets an amazing stop on Troop there. So this is going to be 36 for the Bulldogs. So just like that, another third down. Let's see what the Celtic Tigers line up in here. Got three down linemen here, so a 3-3. Or maybe a dime. Let's see, passes, and gonna be broken up, and almost an interception. So great defense here, and the Celtic Tigers get a stop. They get the stop they need with 6 minutes left to go in the game. And if you're the Bulldogs, this is a very dangerous situation right now, giving Drakeville the ball back with 6 minutes left in the game. And they're going to punt this from their own 20. Reception, you might have a little bit of a run here. Running around and gets it to the 29-yard line. So Drakeville coming back out for just over 5 minutes. Under 6 minutes, I'm sorry. And he's been amazing this whole game. You don't want to jinx him, but no errors yet. 5 minutes and 52 seconds. This is a gun offset Trey. Play action. Dre in the pocket. Running around. Passes deep. And has a man on the sideline. That's a dart. And they're going to, he's going to, oh my gosh. Wow. Let me get a wow in the chat right now. That's DJ Barrow. That's his seventh catch. And that was just an absolute dart by Dre Crowell. Guys, you got to, oh, London's going to challenge that. Did he get that? Did he, if he caught that, that's amazing. If he converted that, that's even more amazing. Let's see this, man. Ooh, I think he had his feet in, man. Yep, he had his feet in. Wow, DJ Barrow, what a catch. What a dart between two defenders. Guys, put the rocket in the chat right now. Where's the rocket at? Wow. That's crazy. Are they going to give him that? And they give it to him. What a play, man. Stat team, you got to go ahead and screenshot that. Oh, my. Empty set right now. Drake roll back. Goes over the middle. Has a man. And that's going to be an injury to Neani. And Neani favoring his shoulder this time. Oh, man. That's going to be devastating. He was hurt last week as well. Went to the back. And does he go to the back this time? And he's going to the locker room this time. So Matt Neani's going to the locker room. And that's absolutely devastating if you are the Celtic Tigers right now. Single back formation. Trey stepping back. Throws over the middle. Has a man. Who is this? Is that Barrow again? No. This time, that's going to be Colvin. Second, two receiving yards. 17 yards, Colvin, an old head. Many of you may have remembered him from season one. He was a rookie then or something like that. Can't remember exactly what how old he was at the time. He was a big part of their offense back in the day. And he is still here on this team. Still someone they use very, very much around along with McFarland. Let's go! One, nine. Offset formation right here. Drake Powell and the gun passes. And, oh, man, almost throws a pick there. Drake Crowell, 20 of 24, 206 yards, one touchdown.
Come on, let's go! Grand 38!
Steps back. Drake Crowell running around, throws a dart. Yes, has a man! And he has another receiver for a first down. 4 minutes and 49 seconds left in this game, and now the Dublin Celtic Tigers, after he gets that to goings, going, gone, as Bill likes to say. Wow. Before the lights went out here, Goins had a touchdown, but the score was reset. But that's going to be Goins who's going to get the first down. So the Celtic Tigers finding some receivers here to take the place of Neani. Guys stepping up. 4 minutes and 16 seconds left to go. Throws a pass, and that's almost an interception. As he tried to get Stimson on the drag right there, Collins interferes with that play. Second and 10. That's why he's playing defense. He fumbled that about three times in his hand. He should have had that interception. Second and 10. Celtic Tigers still keeping Dre in the gun.
Come on, let's go! Grand 38!
Steps back. Running, passes. He has a man right there. That's going to be another pass and a catch. As Worsley's going to get that reception right there. Third and 8. Where is he showing? He got some hands. He got 6 receptions on the day. So getting it done in the passing game. Receiving game. Sorry. Third and 8. From the 18. Drake Well under center. Passes over the middle, has a man. That's going to be Stimson. Gets Stimson down to the 3-yard line. And Coach Roby absolutely loves Jason Stimson out of UNLV, man. Big catch right there. This guy is 6'6 and has breakaway speed. 6'6 breakaway speed. He plays a lot of slot. He's just awesome, man. First and goal from the 3-yard line.
Let's go!
Hand off and oof! Almost as Trey Worsley gets 1 yard on the play. Had a lot of excite bite in him going forward, but gets stopped down at the 2. It's only 1 yard on the play. Celtic Tigers looking for a play here. They got single covers on the outside. Strong. Henderson's in. Let's see what they do here. Henderson blocking. Drake Carroll running around. Almost gets sacked. Throws it to the back of the end zone. And it's going to be an interception. And gets an interception in the end zone. And oh, man, that's got to hurt. That's absolutely got to hurt. That was the same kind of play call that they called last week. But this time, the Bulldogs are all over it. Oh, man, he had a guy right in the bat. He called that same play. That same play last week, it looked like. This time, Dre had to run around to the outside. And that's going to be an interception. Bulldogs, great, great defensive stand right there. So Merritt comes back out, and he has a chance to put this game away. As it's 19-17, 2 minutes and 40 seconds left. Keep a look at those timeouts there of the Celtic Tigers. They still have a chance to do this. Rush coming in, and that's going to be a first down for the moment. Yes, going to be a first down. They get it up to the 39-yard line. So clock still ticking. So essentially the Celtic Tigers have 4 timeouts. They have their own 3, and they have the 2-minute warning. So what they need to do here is it looks like the London Bulldogs are actually going to run this down, which is smart. Very, very smart to run it down. So they'll run it down. Celtic Tigers will have 3 chances, 3 timeouts to stop the clock. Hopefully their defense will be able to stop the Bulldogs. If they don't, then the Bulldogs are going to get a win. And that's how that ball game is gonna end. So let's just see what they do here. 2-minute warning, very, very smart to let that run down now. So London Bulldogs up 19-17 after the aggressive play call by Coach Roby. May have just wanted to run the ball there and get the field goal. Score is 19-17. They hand the ball off to Whedon, and he's going to be stopped in the backfield, and the Celtic Tigers are going to call a timeout. So, 2nd and 12. So, if that's going to be Jason Lindsay on the tackle there, if the Celtic Tigers can stop them here, can stop them from getting a first down, they will have a chance to get the ball back and move downfield for a game-winning field goal or a touchdown. Let's see what they decide to do here. Because they got 4 down linemen, 2 linebackers in the middle. Sniffing out a drag. I think I smell a drag coming here. McDonald in motion. Are they going to run? They're going to run, and Whedon is only going to pick up a couple of yards there. So that's going to be another timeout that's going to be burned by the Celtic Tigers. So I guess the Bulldogs will try to get them to burn another timeout and then punt the ball? Or do they try to take a shot in the pass game? Regardless, you got to get 9 yards. So let's see what they do here. They got 2 wide receivers out wide.
Here we go now. Green,
single back.
39.
Lecky in motion. And they decide to run, and he's going to be stopped. So the Celtic Tigers defense stops the London Bulldogs on 4th and 3rd and 6. And now they're going to get the punt. And Drake Carwell comes back out for what could be the end of the game. Let's see what they're going to do here. Oh, man. And that's just an excellent punt right there. So they're on the 3-yard line. This is an eternity right now. Wow. If Drake Wall can get this team downfield 97 yards for a touchdown or get them into field position, oh my gosh. 23 of 29 on the day, 236 yards, one touchdown. Let's see what the GOAT can do here. Wow. Man-to-man on the outside. So Bulldogs trying to play it close. Drake Well in the end zone. Run around, passes, has a man. And that's going to be pulled out. That's going to be DJ Barrow who's going to get that ball ripped out of his hands. Fans not happy about that. That's going to be a flag on the play.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
Defense, so that's going to bring him out of the end zone for 5 yards. So, yeah, puts him at the 8. So, better for Drake Carroll here.
Still second.
Second
down.
And 5, and he's out of the end zone. Three wide receivers at the top. No one in the slot right now. Probably going to put a linebacker on him. Let's see. Offset. Great throws and has a man down. So he gets the reception. It's 3rd and 1. Can Drake Carroll get this team into field goal position? Throws and goes an interception. And that's how the game is going to end for the Celtic Tigers. As London is going to move on and get another win, get their first win of the season. That's going to be 1-2. And the Celtic Tigers are going to fall to 2-1. As Drake Well just underthrows the ball. Had Gent beat, and he just underthrows the ball. Yep, had Colvin beat. Colvin had Gent beat right there. And that's how this game is going to end, as the Bulldogs are probably going to just kneel this one out. The Tigers don't have any more timeouts. And time will start to expire. If you are interested in joining the RFL, please hit up the Discord. We got Discord links out there. Hit the like button on the video if you liked what you saw today. Don't forget that we have a game actually going on at 8 p.m. tonight. as the Mexico City Diablos are going to take on the Toronto Thunderbirds, man. So another rematch game, as we saw the earlier week one series between them, in which the Thunderbirds came back and LC3 just had an amazing drive down the field and win that game. But check us out at 8 o'clock tonight. And we hope to see you all there, man. Great day. Appreciate you guys for sticking with us through the technical issues. As the Bulldogs get their first win on the season, and the Celtic Tigers are going to fall to 2-1. My name is Rob Roby. I'm signing off, man. Appreciate you guys.